Hola.
Hola.
Bienvenidos a Lightspeed Spanish.
Bienvenidos.
This week we are going to talk about irregular verbs in Spanish. And we're going to go through some of these in present tense. Pues, hablamos de todo en la segunda parte.
Okay, so we have a list of, actually, you know, this is for beginners, but I think I'm going to talk in Spanish.
You talk in Spanish,
because I usually talk in Spanish
English,
in my videos.
Yeah.
Tenemos una lista de verbos irregulares, ¿vale? Hoy vamos a hacer la lista de verbos irregulares en presente, ¿sí? Y luego en el futuro haremos la lista de verbos en pasado o futuro, otros tiempos verbales, ¿sí? Gordon, tú eres el experto en verbos irregulares en español.
Okay.
Y categorías de verbos irregulares en español.
Okay. So I think the best way of coming at the irregular verbs, let's talk about the go verbs, the go-go verbs first. The reason is there's a lot of verbs that take in first person, even though the verb is just looks like a normal verb, there's a G-O appears, yeah? So, for example, we've got tener.
Tener.
Which is the yo.
Tengo.
Tengo. Then we've got hacer. So tener is to have. Hacer, to do or to make, which is?
Hago.
Hago. Then we've got venir, to come.
Vengo.
Poner, to put.
Pongo.
Then decir, to say.
Digo yo.
Salir.
Salgo.
Which is to leave. Salgo. And then traer, to bring.
Traigo.
Okay. So I don't know whether that's the definitive list of the go verbs, but they're very...
It's not the definitive list, for sure.
Most popular.
Pero los más usados. Estos son los verbos irregulares más usados, los 15 verbos más usados en español.
Wow, okay. The interesting thing about go verbs is that although they're very irregular in first person, after that, they're normally okay.
Yeah.
So, for example, if we look at tener,
okay,
right, well, that is irregular all the way through. However, we've got tengo, but then you have, what happens then?
Tienes.
Aha. So although there's an I appears in that one, it takes a normal structure. So you don't have the go going all the way through.
Exactly.
Just on the first one. The same with venir, to come.
Vengo. Vienes. Viene.
Yeah.
Venimos. Venís. Vienen.
So again, the I appears in. It's a bit of a theme, okay? So...
Not in all of them.
Not in all.
Some of them are just irregular. Son irregulares en go, en la primera. Y después son regulares.
Yeah.
Y otros son irregulares en la primera y en el resto.
And then beyond, like decir, so you've got digo, okay, and then
dices.
So the I stays in, so the E drops out and the I comes in, yeah? So again, bit of a minefield with the go verb, so you have to look at them carefully. But then let's move on to have a look at the verbs that take a Y in the first person as well. So we've got ser. This one is imprescindible. You've got to learn ser. So how does ser, which is to be, how does it conjugate?
Yo soy.
With a Y, soy.
And then, well, it's irregular in English as well. I am, you are. It's irregular in
one of the
both
very
languages.
Few irregular English verbs.
Yo soy, tú eres, él es o ella es, nosotros somos, vosotros sois y ellos son.
Okay, we've got a song about the conjugation,
sí,
there.
Eso es, eso es.
Probably the most seen video that we've got. Okay, so soy, yeah. And it's interesting if you want to say I am a weeping willow. How do you say it in Spanish?
Soy un sauce llorón.
Yeah. So, when you see the bottle of soy sauce in England, Spanish people think it's saying, I'm a willow tree. Soy sauce.
Ay, Dios mío, los chistes británicos.
No, no, you told me it years ago. Así que
los chistes españoles.
Okay, so then we've got estar, which is the sister of ser, to be. Yeah. Again with a Y. How does that one go?
Yo estoy, tú estás, él está, ella está. Nosotros estamos, vosotros estáis, y ellos están.
Okay. So, regular, really, apart from this estoy, and okay, ser is pretty irregular all the way through. And then we've got ir. Again, ir is a weird one. IR, to go, but I go is?
Voy. Voy.
In fact, it doesn't resemble ir in any of the conjugations. How does that conjugate?
Yo voy, tú vas, él va, ella va. Nosotros vamos, vosotros vais, y ellos van.
And you'll be hearing Cynthia using vosotros as one of the persons. Here in Spain, it's used very in a very big way. Please, if you're learning Spanish, don't think that you can get away without learning vosotros. Learn it. It's worth it, because even if you're in Latin America, you're going to talk to Spanish people and you're going to hear them using vosotros. Okay? So,
if not, you can use the third person singular and plural for usted y ustedes.
Ustedes, yeah. Mm-hmm.
The same person.
But I made that mistake.
He, she, and usted is the same person, and they and ustedes is the same person.
Sure. All it is, I was in Mexico and I said, and somebody said, we don't use vosotros here, don't bother learning. And I went, brilliant.
Es la lucha.
That'll save me loads of time. It didn't. It wasted loads of time for me, because then I had to learn it later on.
Mi español es mejor, ¿no?
Sí.
No aprendas vosotros. Bueno, en mi opinión, es bueno saberlo. Mm-hmm. Aunque no lo utilices todos los días, es bueno saberlo porque lo vas a oír.
Exactly.
Simplemente.
Yeah. It's the same with the boss from Argentina, claro. Uruguay, and all of that. It's worthwhile just becoming familiar with it, because claro. You're going to hear it.
Claro, exacto.
Yeah. Okay. Vale. So just quickly, we'll run through a few of the irregular verbs. Poder. This is a verb you've got to have in your pocket. Poder, to be able. To can. Mm-hmm. To can. I know that doesn't exist, but that's how it works.
Can, yeah.
To can. Can you? Can you can? Okay.
Another regular verb in English as well.
Yeah.
Can.
Can, exactly. Mm-hmm. So how does that conjugate? Poder.
Yo puedo, tú puedes, él puede, nosotros podemos, vosotros podéis, y ellos pueden.
Mm-hmm. So the U-E goes in there as well. Just a little tip. No matter how irregular the verb, typically in the nosotros and the vosotros, it isn't irregular. It goes mm-hmm. back to form, okay? Goes back to the form. Not in every verb, but nearly, mm-hmm. okay? Okay, and then we've got querer.
Querer.
To want.
Yo quiero, or to love as well.
Also, yeah.
Yo quiero, tú quieres, él quiere. Nosotros queremos, vosotros queréis, ellos quieren.
Y yo te quiero.
Eso es, muy bien. Mm-hmm. Y yo te quiero a ti.
Qué bien, me alegro. Okay, and then what about saber, to know?
Saber.
That's irregular, yeah.
Yo sé. Mm. Tú sabes, él sabe. Nosotros sabemos, vosotros sabéis, ellos saben.
Okay. So just one conjugation, first person is irregular. And then the last one, ver, to see.
Yo veo, tú ves, él ve, nosotros vemos, vosotros veis, ellos ven.
And that verb appears in a very, very, very famous song, which goes, veo, veo,
¿qué ves? Eso es.
Una cosita.
Y un tip. En español, la V se pronuncia como la B.
La B.
No es ven, ¿vale? Es ven. Más similar a la B que la V.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay, so what we're going to do, as we continue on, we're going to do some other videos taking these verbs into other tenses, okay? And just helping you with
eso
that.
Es. Muy bien.
Pues muchas gracias, Cynthia.
A ti, Gordon.
Y gracias a vosotros.
Muy bien, y ahora...
Ahora nos vamos.
Y nos vemos.
Hasta luego.
Adiós.